With if statements, we can allow pieces of code to only be executed when a condition is true. You make an if statement by writing if followed by a condition. A condition, or statement, is something that's either true or false. For example, 5 is higher than 9. After the condition, we put a then. Below, you put all the code you want inside the if statement. Put the code of the x going up inside the if statement. And we finish the if statement with an and. If we run the game, you will see that our rectangle isn't moving anymore. This is because the statement, 5 higher than 9, is false. If we were to say 5 lower than 9, the statement is true, and the code inside the if statement will execute. With this, we can for example make x go up to 700 and then make it stop with x lower than 700. If you want to check if a variable is equal to another variable, we have to use two equal signs. So, for equals sign 7. One equal sign is for assigning, two equal signs is for comparing. If you want to check if something is higher than or equal to a number, we write a higher than sign followed by an equal sign. Of course, same works with lower than. A variable can also be true or false. This type of variable is what we call a boolean. I'll make a new variable called move and say it equals true. And in our if statement, I'll check if move equals true. Remember, two equal signs. Checking if it's true is actually redundant. We're basically checking if it's true that it is true. Simply using move as a condition is good enough. If we want to check if a move is false, we put a not in front of it. If not move, then. If we want to check if a number is not equal to another number, we use a tilde. So, for tilde equals sign 5. We can also assign true or false to a variable with a statement. So, move equals 6 higher than 3, for example. If we check if move is true and then change move to false inside the if statement, it's not as if we jump out of the if statement. All the code below will still be executed. Let's make a rectangle move based on if we press the right arrow key. For this we use the function love.keyboard.isDown. Make sure the D of isDown is uppercase. This type of casing is what we call camel casing. We start the name in lowercase, then every word's first character is uppercase. Pass the string right as argument for isDown. Now when we press the right arrow key, the rectangle will move to the right. We can also use else to tell our game what to do when the if statement is false. For example, let's say our rectangle moves to the left when we don't press right. Simply copy the code for moving the rectangle and change the plus to a minus. We can also check if another statement is true, after the first is false, with else if. Let's make it so that this code is only executed when holding the left arrow key. So now it will check if the right arrow key is down. If not, it will check if the left arrow key is down. Make a new variable called y and replace the y position of the rectangle with y. Now simply copy the code of the horizontal movement and replace x with y. And finally, change right to down and left to up. There we go, a moving rectangle. In the next video, I will be talking about tables. Thanks for watching.